great. It's fantastic.
It's great to be here, Safra.
Yes.
Thank you.
It is so fun. We were talking, last time we'd been together was in Mexico City. You could almost not get me out of there, all my favorite stuff. And he's promised me a visit to a bakery next time I come. So that could be pretty, pretty dangerous. But, you know, everyone here knows the world is moving faster and there are more challenges, whether it's, listen, what have we been through? Supply chain, now we've got inflation, all of those things. Maybe you could share with us some of the things that you're doing to deal with just these challenges.
Well, first of all, Safra, let me say thank you. Thank you for having us, and thank you for being in person, as you mentioned, not on a box square. And I would say that on behalf of our 138,000 associates, it's an honor and a privilege to be this morning with you guys. So challenges, what can I say? I guess that anyone here on the audience has immense challenges. What have been our challenges? Well, what can we say? Energy, commodities, labor shortages, talent attrition, and we could go on and on. But what have we done? I think that we've stayed the course. And why do I say we've stayed the course? This December, we will be 77 years old. And I would say that even since from our inception, we've had maybe three constant pillars. One is a relentless pursuit of growth. Second is to invest in brands. We're a company of brands. Some of you here in the US might know Thomas's, Entenmann's, Sara Lee. If you're further abroad, Bimbo, or even Takis now, it's one of our core brands. And we've been a company that we've invested more than 60% of our profits every year back to the business to invest in technology, to invest in CapEx, and to invest in acquisitions. So that pursuit of growth has helped us in these times, but also I would say starting, and let me use the word starting, to leverage data, insights, and above all, we've been, I would say, intelligently pushing revenue growth management categories, channel countries, and so we've been able to navigate so far successfully. So that's a thought.
It's very important. I mean, the truth is that even in downturns, there are incredible opportunities, especially for those folks who have been, as I said, bold early on, decided to do this enormous transformation. And, you know, tell us first of all, though, how you decided to take that step, and then what's in store for this next year and the year after?
Well, first of all, I think that for the audience, we've been a Oracle partner for the last maybe 21, 22 years. Maybe someone will correct me later. So that partnership has been about challenging ourselves, about harnessing learnings, about asking, and I would say, and I always tell Luis Meisler this, that we have a positive tension that keeps us going, right? You ask, we give, we ask, you give, and so we keep on improving. And with that in mind, maybe 6-7 years ago, when we chartered our digital journey, we took two decisions. One was to be a cloud-first company, and the other one to leverage all the data that we have. So ERP, the ERP fusion up with you guys, it's been a journey. We've, I would say, masked it as an upgrade. Actually, it isn't. It's been a very hard job of many. This year, we're in 33 countries, so by year's end, we'll be about 70% done. But I think that the real challenge is the next step. It's about leveraging all the Oracle technology that we've deployed and actually seeing the end-to-end value chain that we have. For the audience, we operate 206 bakeries worldwide. We have a 55,000 distribution network that serves give or take 3 million points of sales every week. So for us, all that data and all that visibility will surely push us to be even more efficient, to have, you know, fresher products. And what we want to say is nutritious and baked and nutritious goods in the hands of all. So what's for 2025? 23, it's finish up, and then Leverage everything that we've done.
And do more, yeah. I mean, there's nothing more important in the world than food security and making sure that people have food around the world, and that what you've done already has been incredible. However, I know that you're not even done. I mean, how does sustainability factor into your growth?
Well, I guess that sustainability, I would not say that's part of our DNA, but it's been part of our strategy maybe over the last 10 years. We've been pushing hard for sustainability, and I can shed, if I may, I'll share a story with the audience. In a small outfit that we have in Mexico, with our own technology, we developed our own electric vehicles. That was a small, you know, pilot, a test lab. Well, from that entity, we've deployed 1,300 electric vehicles made by a baker, as I would say the OEMs weren't ready for us. So that's part of our sustainability job. And I would say that maybe by year's end, Safra, we would be maybe 95 or 95 plus of all our energy in our bakeries would move from renewable sources. And our commitment is basically to be what we're calling sustainability by design as we move forward.
That's fantastic. That is incredible. And, you know, joining that with our cloud, which is the most sustainable, we get two for the price of one on this. So it's incredibly exciting. So I want all of you, next time you go through the bread line, you should have the joy that I have every single time, because I think about Bimbo, Grupo Bimbo, and what a wonderful partnership we have really built.
That's
together. I thank you. You know, one of the challenges for a company like us is to is to make sure we're not focused on ourselves, but focused on you. And I hope that you have felt that in our partnership.
I would say so, Safra. Maybe over the last 24, 30 months, we've seen a closer approach, a challenge, I would say a very respectful but challenging relationship, and answers and feedback. And I think that has kept us moving. And I believe that the asks that we put in front of Oracle, I think it's for the benefit of the product that we're leveraging, and surely more will. And I think it's about enabling the learnings and harnessing the opportunities that the future brings, and that's what we're in this journey, and we want to get over it and then move on. But yes, it's been a journey.
It just makes me so happy, and I want to thank you. I want to thank you for partnering with us, and I want to thank you for sharing the journey with everyone here, because I hope they're learning about the incredible possibilities. And for you, you know, even in downturns, the strong have opportunities. So this could be an entirely exciting time for you all. So thank you.
Thank you, Safra.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Safra.